Over the past year, I've posted quite a few designs for homemade do-it-yourself antennas. Each antenna has been tested to be sure it receives good over-the-air station reception, and many of them have been built by numerous people. The number one question I am always asked is, will this antenna be good for my particular situation? Well, that's a complex question that I can't really answer, but what I can do is put together this episode where I will take six of my antennas and pit them head-to-head in a showdown so you can see which one might be best for you. So pick your favorite and let's see how it comes out in the testing. Are you ready? Let's hop to it. Here are the six antennas that I will be testing today. I will post links to each of their episodes in the description. Note that all the antennas here are primarily designed for UHF reception, but locally they can all pull in one available high band VHF channel which broadcasts on RF channel 8. The first up is my most popular antenna, the Hoop. Its build episode has over 100,000 views. This particular Hoop is the one that I keep in my A-frame camper, and I can tell you it does a nice job of receiving TV signals. It is a multi-directional antenna design, so once it's set up, I don't have to fiddle with it. Clean, simple, and effective, this is a great antenna for a lot of uses. Second up is the Octagon antenna. It's based on a modified Hoop design and has a built-in reflector. I made this one as an indoor antenna, so it has a solid aluminum reflector, but it can be made with 1/2-inch screen hardware cloth instead. Constructed mostly from 1/2-inch PVC, adding the reflector helps increase reception over the basic Hoop antenna. Also multi-directional, this antenna is one of my more involved constructions. Next is the smallest antenna in this test, the 3-diamond antenna. This was designed for a friend that wanted an inconspicuous antenna that could be mounted outside. Still multi-directional and made on a horizontal plane, each diamond is constructed from solid 10-gauge wire. Although simple to make, it does take some basic woodworking skills to complete. Number 4 is the Tritenna. This design switches things up from the horizontal layout to one with 3 vertical hoops. By aiming each hoop arm based on an equilateral triangle, the reception field is still very multi-directional. This actual antenna is being used by Mrs. Hoptwood on the TV in her office and she loves it. The elements on this antenna are each made by twisting 3 16-gauge galvanized wires into one. This makes it almost as effective as using 10-gauge copper, but at a much lower price. This antenna is also pretty easy to make if you have some basic woodworking skills. The fifth antenna is the pie pan reflector. Many people thought this wasn't a serious design, but it actually works very well. The aluminum pie pan acts as a reflector, increasing the gain, range, and focus of the antenna. The element is 10-gauge copper, and the body is constructed from 1/2-inch PVC. This antenna does receive signals from a fairly wide direction, but the primary focus is pretty concentrated. Due to the wind resistance of the pie pan, I only recommend this antenna for indoor or attic use. Making this antenna is a bit more involved. The final antenna in this test is the double hoop antenna with reflector. Originally made with 16-gauge galvanized steel hoops, I since modified it with solid 10-gauge elements. Using PVC board and a 1/2-inch hardware cloth reflector make this antenna suitable for either attic or outdoor mounting. This is the largest of the antennas in the test, and it has more concentrated reception focus than most of the other antennas. This antenna takes a moderate skill level to build. So those are the antennas. Let me show you how I will now run the tests. Here's my antenna test room. It's on the second floor of my home, and I use it to test all my antennas. One thing I'm doing differently today is instead of running the scan on the TV and using its limited 5-bar graph to read signal strength, I'm going to route the antenna through a tuner box made by E-Matic. The signal strength meter that it has displays from 0 to 100%, so I will get a much more accurate readout. I'll clamp each antenna to this PVC mast, attach a 6-foot piece of coax with a matching transformer, and connect it to the tuner's input. The tuner's output is via an HDMI cable to the TV. Since multi-directional antennas sometimes still have a sweet spot, I'll run a scan and rotate the antenna to get the highest overall signal strength. I'll rerun the scan to see if I can pick up any additional stations. For the two antennas that are more directional, I will aim them at some distant stations to see if I can receive them. If I can get any of them, I will record their signal strengths. I will also adjust the antenna direction and try to find the best direction for overall signal strength. First up is my camper's antenna, the hoop. I'm very familiar with this antenna's performance, so it should make a good baseline for comparison. Next up, the octagon. Now the three diamond gets a chance to show us what it can do. It's time to test the tri-tenna. It's the pie pan reflector's turn. And to finish off the testing, it's the double hoop antenna with reflector. The testing is done, so how did the six compare? Let me start by showing a basic range and direction chart for my location. The X's represent TV stations or groups of stations. You can see a few interesting points. First, the stations are not in one or even two directions from my home, but in a few different directions. Notice how most of my channels fall within 30 miles of distance. There are a few in the 31 to lower 40 mile range. I don't have any stations located from the mid 40 mile range all the way to over 60 miles, so I am unable to test my antennas for that distance. Finally, I do have a few stations that are over 60 miles and one that's just over 70 miles away. Here's a list of all the channels and subchannels that I can receive in the area. There are 66 of them. Okay, let's look at the chart of how these antennas performed in this test. I've listed the 16 main channels across the top. The antennas are listed down the left side and the chart shows the signal meter percentage I recorded. Only the pie pan with reflector and the double hoop with reflector could receive all 66 of them, but I had to rotate the antennas to get them all. If you look at the chart, you can see that all of the antennas did a really good job of picking up signals. Generally, signal strengths were fairly even on the closer channels, such as 5, 11, 17, 22, 28, etc. It was only when the stations started to exceed the 30-mile range or had weaker powered transmitters did the reception start to vary. I use certain specific stations as markers to see how my antennas perform. The first station I use is Channel 4, the local PBS station. Although it is fairly close to my house, the transmitter is low powered, so it can be hard for an antenna to receive it. Next, I check channel 62. It's another marker station. It's in the opposite direction from the main group of transmitters and can be difficult to pick up too. All the antennas were able to get it in this test. Finally, I look at the distant channels, 2, 7, and 33. These are the hardest to pick up. All three of these are over 60 miles from my location, and only the directional antennas were able to get all of them, if I aim them towards the transmitter's direction. So which of the antennas is the winner? Well, actually they all are. Antennas are designed for specific uses. There really isn't one size fits all, and which antenna is best for you depends on your situation. Rather than declare a winner or loser, I'm going to review each antenna's performance and give you my suggestions on where it should be used. The hoop antenna does a really good job of picking up signals up to about 30 to 35 miles. Since it's multi-directional, it's a good antenna if you need to get stations simultaneously from different directions. It's light and easy to build and works well for RVs and boats. The octagon antenna takes the hoop antenna and adds even more gain. If you have weak or marginal signals coming from multiple directions, the added reflector will help pull them in. The operating range for this antenna is up to 40 miles. This will work well in many suburban and some rural areas. The three diamond antenna had the shortest range of the group, but it still might be the perfect antenna for your needs. If you are in a more urban location and have multiple stations all around you, this is a great choice. The optimum range for this antenna is within 20 miles. Very inexpensive and easy to make, the low profile and small dimensions would work well on an apartment balcony or tucked in a corner of your living room. The tri-tenna is a great overall antenna. Only about 19 inches across, it has really good gain and receives a station that was over 60 miles away. This antenna gives you the advantages of a multi-directional antenna with a range that is getting pretty close to a directional antenna. This antenna would be best in almost all situations, like suburban or rural locations, or even for an RV or boat. If I had to pick the best overall antenna for the average user and situation, I would absolutely recommend this antenna. The pie pan with reflector is an amazing antenna. Its reflector allows it to pull in stations over 70 miles away, and that's pretty impressive for such a small antenna. The drawback to any directional antenna is the reception field is much more focused, so this antenna isn't the best choice for receiving stations from multiple directions. It also has to be mounted out of the wind, so it's only suitable for attic or indoor use. Even so, if your station transmitters are located in the same direction and they are far away, this is a really good choice. Last is the big double hoop antenna with reflector. If you are looking for an outside mounted antenna with long range and high gain, this should be your first choice. The double hoops and large reflector provide a clear, stable picture that outperforms everything else tested here. This antenna works best for rural locations with most of your stations within a compass arc of around 130 degrees. Although it's a little more difficult to construct, it is well worth the effort if you need the performance that it provides. It picked up stations that were over 70 miles away. With a wider reception field than the pie pan, it pulls in signals simultaneously from more directions and needs less adjusting and repositioning. I hope this gives you a better idea of which antenna is best for your situation. Remember that these results are based on my particular location. Your location will have its own variables, so your results may vary. It's always best to do your research. I recommend watching my episode on how to use the website rabbitears.info to see the specifics of your location. It will tell you things like available stations, signal strength, reception quality, terrestrial interference, and more. I will include a link to the video. Please high-five the like icon, jingle the bell, and subscribe to my channel. I have a couple of new antennas that I'm working on, and I will have them posted soon. Until then, keep watching TV.